Once again, this is Jeff Scott of Rankin Technical College, and I've been going over the PowerPoint presentations along with some code for Muroc Android Programming 2nd Edition by Joel Muroc for the AWD 1112-1112 Java Programming class. We're in the middle of Chapter 7 on how to work with themes and styles. I just went over the entire styles section, so now it's time to go over the themes section. So I'm on page 210 of the text, and as mentioned on that page, it says, now that you know how to work with styles, you're ready to take another look at themes. For example, you're ready to learn how to modify a theme. So figure 7.7, which is on page 211, and it's also shown on the slide here, shows how to modify a theme such as the Hollow theme. Here are the theme named App Theme that you see at the top. Is a custom theme that contains three item elements. It's the same stuff that you saw before. Each of these item elements uses its name attribute to specify an attribute that corresponds with a style from the inherited theme, the hollow.light.dark action bar theme. After specifying the style that you want to override, each of these item elements uses its body to specify the custom style that overrides the inherited style. Now, one thing to mention about this, I'm going over this stuff for completeness sake, but we have 40 days to cover this stuff, and we're just going to be using basically the default, which is fine with me. If you want to modify a theme, you often need to do some research and experimentation to find out exactly which attributes and exactly which styles you want to modify. When you work with Android Studio, you can use the autocomplete feature to see what's available to you. All right, and if you need more information, you can go on to the developer.android.com site and you can view the API documentation for the theme array that's defined in the r.stylable class. And let me get that here. There it is. Now, figure 7.8, which is shown on the screen here, or at least part of it is, and also in figure 7.8 on page 213, shows how to modify the app compat theme. It works pretty much like modifying a built-in theme like the Hollow theme, but it's a little trickier because you need to specify whether to override a style from the App Compat support library or a style from the Android operating system. And as mentioned on the page, this oftentimes is going to involve some trial and error on your part. The API documentation for the attributes from the App Compat theme is shown here, and the styles.xml file for the V7 App Compat support library is shown down below it. Again, I'm trying to go over this at least somewhat for the sake of completeness, but we're going to be doing virtually nothing with this stuff. My take on this is with 40 days and me wanting to go over the material in all of section 1 of the book, chapters 1 to 4, all of section 2 in the book, chapters 5 through 9, and some of the stuff like themes, etc., menus, just and fragments in 7, 8, 9, just briefly. I'm going to skip 10, 11, and 12, which is the newsreader app, but I'd like to spend more time on the task list app in chapters 13 through 16 because it goes over database. And again, we'll talk about Chapter 17, how to deploy the app, but I will lecture on these PowerPoints for Chapter 18 on locations and maps, but we're not going to go over those in class. All right, so pages 214 and 215 in Figure 7.9, the author talks about how to modify a theme depending on the API. So if you want to use a different one, in other words, if you want to modify use the material theme for API 21 and later fall back on the Holo theme for older APIs, you can do something similar to this. Now, Android uses a series of built-in styles to control the appearance of the text for a theme. Okay, if you look at figure 7.10, you can see some of these styles. If you want to change the text appearance for a single widget, you can set its text appearance property to a new text appearance style. But if you want to modify the text for multiple widgets, you may want to customize the text appearance styles for a theme. And that's what's shown in figure 7.10 on pages 216 and 217. On pages 218 and 219, figure 7.11, that you see at the beginning of it on your screen here, it lists some of the built-in themes available from Android. So the ones that are shown there are older. The theme.light has a white background. The theme.black has a black background. The theme.light.noTitleBar, white background, no title bar. Theme.black.noTitleBar, black background, no title bar. The theme.dialog has a dialog box with a black background. The Holo themes, the first one, theme.holo, black background, theme.holo.dialog, with a black background as a dialog, theme.holo.noActionBar, black background, no action bar, theme.holo.light, white background, theme.holo.light.dialog, white background as a dialog, theme.holo.light.noActionBar, white background with no action bar, theme.holo.light.darkActionBar, white background, dark action bar. Finally, some material themes, and again, they pretty much follow the same way. So if you want a list of all of the built-in themes available for an activity, you display the activity itself. So you display the activity itself in the graphical layout editor, and then you use the drop-down list to see what's available to you. All right. And finally, we're for themes, on how to apply themes. You use the Android manifest.xml file to apply themes to an entire application or to a specific activity. If you want to apply the theme to the entire application, you use the theme attribute of the application element to specify a theme. That's what's shown in the first example here. If you want to apply a theme to a specific activity, you use the theme attribute of the activity element for it to specify the theme. And that's the second example that you see right here. Now, the last example that you see down here is very similar to the first one. The difference is this specifies a custom theme. So you can use the Android manifest.xml file to apply a theme to the entire application or to a specific activity. To apply a theme to the entire application, you use the theme attribute of the application element to specify the theme. That was shown back in figure 7.2 that's on page 201. To apply a theme to a specific activity, you use the theme attribute of the activity element to specify a theme. You can use the theme element to specify a built-in theme or a custom theme. Finally, when you specify a theme for the application and activity levels, the theme at the activity level overrides the theme at the application level. So the more specific one will override the more general one. Finally, the last part of the chapter, pages 222 and 223, talk about working with colors. So So if you want to work with colors, it's generally considered a best practice to begin by adding a colors.xml file in your res/values directory. Here is an example. As you can see, you can add color elements for each and any color you might want to define. Within the color element, you use the name attribute to specify a name for the color, like primary, secondary, tertiary, background, dark, and light. Together, these colors provide a color scheme that can be used for an app. Within the body of the color element, all right, so within here, as the author mentions, you can use a hex value to specify an RGB or red, green, blue value for the color. It works very similar to the way we used to do it in HTML and CSS. All right. So there are examples in here on how to apply colors to a widget. And there are three ways that are shown here. First, as shown in the first example, you can use a hex value to specify a color. Second, you can use the name for a custom color, and that's the one, this color primary is the one that we set right here. And thirdly, you can use a style to apply a color. You can also apply a color by overriding the default colors of the theme. I believe that's what they're showing you in here. All right. The colors.xml for Android API 6.0, the URL is shown there on the bottom of the slide. Now that's pretty much, yep, that's it for this chapter. So, what we did in this chapter is we were introduced to the subject of themes which are applied to an app or to an activity, and styles which are applied to individual widgets. For small apps, you might decide that the default styles are adequate, since most of the stuff that we are doing is pretty much on the small app side. That's the way we're going to do it. However, for larger apps, you might want to create a style sheet to apply formatting, or even, you know, after we get going, you might want to apply your own custom style sheet. All right, this chapter is just meant to be an introduction to styles and themes, and a little bit on color, but it's by no means a comprehensive list. So when you come back next, we are going to be going over chapter 8, which is on how to work with menus and preferences. So we'll be back to discuss that in just a few minutes.